Hello friends, welcome to our channel where we are presenting lessons in mathematics. Remember, these lessons are meant for people doing the GCSE exams, all right? Grade 8 and 9 can benefit. That is, if you're writing 9 internal or external, then 10, 11, 12 can as well benefit. Those that are writing the grade 12 internal exams, as well as those that are doing GCE. So if you have been wondering as to how you can pass these exams, if you have been failing mathematics repeatedly, here is a clinic. We are providing a clinic for mathematics. All right? We are here to see to that you are able to sit for these exams without challenges, because we are trying by all means to put all our energies into this thing so that we provide the best. All right? So in this presentation, we are dealing with the quadratic equations. And I must be quick to state that this is lesson 2 under quadratic equations. So for this presentation, we are trying to see how we can solve quadratic equations using factorization method. But now, this factorization method is specifically centered or based on the factors of quadratic expression. Again, I must remind you that we have presented lessons on algebra. So this approach relies so much on algebra, factorization part and algebra. Alright? So if at all you could have some challenges, I would advise you to go back to our videos, check where there's algebra, go to factorization part, especially where there's quadratic expression. See what you were able to do there. You'll be able to see what we are doing. Okay, there will be like a jump start, alright, to this thing. Okay. Nevertheless, we can still handle, even if you're doing it for the first time, I hope we'll be able to explain at length. Okay? So, the question says, solve the following equations. Alright? So, we have the first one, which is x squared plus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation in the sense that the highest degree is a 2. So, the highest power is a 2. That's what you mean by a degree. What that means is that when you solve, there is a possibility, mark my words, there's a possibility that you might get two solutions to this problem. By solutions, we are looking for values that will satisfy this equation. Now, look at the terms that we have here. We have got 1, 2, 3, all right? And there's a 2. Hence, this part alone, this part, without the equal sign, is a quadratic expression. So we can try to apply this if you are able to factorize. It means, therefore, you must use the other approaches. But for this, all these examples or these questions, yeah, they are able to be factorized. So, just this alone minus this, it is an expression, which we are calling a quadratic expression. So now, if you are dealing with a quadratic expression, there is what we are calling a product, a sum, and the factors. Again, in order for you to be able to do that, you need to identify what we call the constants. Alright? That is A, B, and you isolate the C here. Now, what is A? A is the coefficient of a term that has power 2, regardless of the position. So, our coefficient here is a 1. If you can't see anything, there's a 1. If there's a negative, it means it's negative 1. Alright? Our B is what? 7. And our C is what? 12. So now, how do I get the product? Product is equal to A times what? C. So what is our product? Our A is what? Times, what is our C? 12. So our product here is 12. Alright? That's how you deal with these things. Then you go to what we call sum. Sum is equal to B. And what is our B? 7. Meaning that our sum is what? 7. So now, what that means, therefore, is you must find the factors of what? 12. If I have 12, what are the factors of 12? Now, when dealing with factors, you must look at these factors in terms of both negative and positive numbers. So, when you look at the factors of 12, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 4, plus or minus 6, plus or minus 4. All these are factors of what? 12. But now, you watch the two numbers where, when you multiply, the numbers will give you 12. But their sum should be what? 7. So which two numbers can give us 7 when we add? You have 1 and 6, for example. Alright? Then 3 and what? 4. This is the two set. But now, when you multiply these, what do you get? You get 6. So these 4 off. They don't qualify. How about these? This by that you get 12. When you add, you have got 7. So these are our factors. So our factors here are what? 3 and what? 4. I hope it's clear. Okay? So now, because the variable that is here is x, so it's like here I've got 3x and 4x there. So what would disappear is this part. Because I'll say 3x plus 4x will give me 7x. So I'll rewrite everything apart from this. So I'll say x squared, this is positive, plus 3x. Again, 4 is positive, plus 4x, plus what? 12. The question is, why are we introducing x here? Because the variable that is there is what? X. Then here, this should be equal to 0. Now, it's not an ordinary quadratic expression, but it is a quadratic equation. So here, you now go for the common factor, highest common factor. X squared and 3x, you have x, you open the bracket. X into x squared, x, plus what? X into 3x, it's 3, you close, plus. You have 4x and 12. What is the highest common factor here? So we must deal with 4 first, 12. It is 4, open bracket. Why am I saying open bracket? Without dealing with the x. Here there is x and there is no x. So the only common factor is a 4. Alright? So 4 into 4x, you have x, plus 4 into 12, you have got 3. The answer is what? 0. So this and this, they are common, isn't it? So it is only written once. So you have got x plus 3. Then you also have, these you put them in brackets, x plus 4. Then from here, you apply the zero product. Okay? The zero product. So I can come here. So now, we are saying x plus 3 should be equal to 0. Or it is x plus 4 that is 0, or both. So x is going to be 0 minus 3. So x is negative 3. Or, I hope it's clear. You have x is equal to 0 minus 4, or x is negative 4. So that's how you do this. So you first understand how to factorize the quadratic expression. I keep on repeating. Go back to algebra, specifically scroll down, you check for factorization under quadratic expression. It will be very, very helpful. Okay, good. So we can go to B. Now, B is saying M minus 3 is equal to 40. Now, you cannot say, if you get this, you say this is equal to that. No, here you cannot apply that because this is not a zero here. Alright? So you cannot say this is equal to that. No, no. So the first thing that you must do is to rewrite this equation into the standard form, right? The standard form is ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. You can check lesson 1 where we gave a definition. Okay? That's a standard form. So you write it into this form. Okay, so what we are going to do is we distribute the m with it. So your m by m will be m squared minus m by 3, 3m. Now, here, remember our aim is to have a 0 here, isn't it? So we have minus 4 here. Is equal to what? 0. If there is plus here, minus. If there is minus here, it will be plus. Good. So this is what we have. So what we are going to do here, we get the product, sum, and the factors. Remember we are saying our sum is b. And our b is negative what? 3. Our product is A times C. Alright? What is our A? A is 1. Times C, negative 40. The answer is negative 40. So, get two numbers where, when you multiply them, they'll give you negative 40. But when you add them, they should give you negative what? 3. So, Which numbers? We can have 5 and 8, right? When you multiply this, it'll give you 40. But what? The sign here is negative. When you add this, the answer will be 13. But we're interested in negative 3. So which of these should have a negative? It's this. So that this by that is a negative 40. When you add, you get negative 3. So our factors are 5 and negative what? 8. I hope that is clear, friends. Please take note that our product is negative 40. Our factors are 5 and negative what? 8. Okay? Now, because the variable that is here is m, so I'll distribute m there. So we have m squared plus, because this is positive, 5m minus 8m. So this part is represented by this. Minus 40, the answer is what? 0. Alright? Then here we go for the common factors. So if you have m squared and 5m, our common factor here, highest common factor is m. Alright, so factor it out. So m into m squared is m plus m into 5m. So 5m divided by m, you have 5. We close. Okay, now you must be careful with this part, especially on the sign. Because we need to have a factor here and equal to 0. But what is here should be equal to this. Now, since this is negative and negative, you identify a sign that will convert these into positive. Because here it's positive. And the sign is what? I think negative. Okay, so we have 8m and 40. With the letter, we don't have a common factor, but I'll deal with the numbers. What's the highest common factor of 8 and 40? I think the highest common factor is 8 itself. Alright? So negative and negative will divide. So you remain with m. Negative and negative will divide. You remain with what? 5. So now here we have a common factor again. M plus 5. So that's what you get. M plus 5. Again, this and that, you put them in brackets. Both these are the factors. Okay. So this means that M plus 5 is equal to 0. Or it is the M minus 8. That is equal to what? 0. If m plus 5 is equal to 0, then what is m? M must be negative 5. So 0 minus 5. So m is equal to negative 5. Alright? Or m is equal to 0 plus 8. Therefore, m is equal to what? 8. It means you have solved that problem. I hope it's clear, friends. And deal with the third one. Right, so here we can check the starting point. You check if at all there is a common factor, all right, so that you reduce things, reduce the numbers. It's better to deal with the smaller numbers, it makes your job easy. So you have got 4, 10, and 6. Do you have a common factor? Yes, the common factor is 2. So you can divide first by 2, by 2, by 2, and by 2 throughout, all right. So the 2 into 4, we have got 2p squared, minus 2 into 10p, you have got 5p, minus 3 is equal to 0. Alright? Do you have a common factor? No. So, again we apply the same. You say, what is our sum? What is our product, sum and the factors here. Product, we are saying it is A times what? C. What is our A? 2. 2 times negative 3. The answer is negative what? 6. Our sum is B. And what is our sum? Negative 5. Good. Now, you're going to find the factors of what? 6. What are the factors of 6? 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 6. So, two numbers where when you multiply them, they should give you negative 6. So you have 1 and this one. Then you also have 2 and what? 3. Okay? So these numbers, when we multiply them, they'll give us 6 just as a number. But now, it must be a negative. Right? One of them should be a negative. Now, if you put here a negative, there's no way that you'll get a negative 5. If you put here a negative, there's no way you arrive at negative 5. So it means we deal with these guys. Alright? So, which of these should be negative? If you put a negative here, the answer will be positive here. Because it will be negative 1 plus 6. Meaning that it will be positive 5. But our interest is to get negative. Meaning that the negative should be with this guy. So, it means our common factors, or our factors here, will be 1 and the negative 6. Because 1 times negative 6 is negative 6. But 1 plus negative 6 is negative 5. So, I think we are good to go. So, now, here we are going to say 2p squared plus. Why am I putting plus? Because this is plus. Plus 1. 1 by p, because there is p here, I'll put p. Minus 6p minus 3 is equal to 0. What is tempered with it is this part. Okay. That is the part that is tempered with. Anything else remains intact. Alright, so now we go for the common factor. 2p squared and p, I think it is a p. P into 2p squared, of 2p plus 1. Alright? As the case was here, so you must pick the appropriate sign. So we have a negative. 6p and 3, we go for 3 as our least common factor. Alright? Then here, negative and negative will produce a positive inside. 3 into 6 is 2. So we have 2p. Negative to negative is a plus 1. Then everything is equal to what? 0. Okay, so I can erase here. Okay, so what is common here? DZ 2p plus 1. Alright? And p minus 3 is equal to what? 0. So either this is equal to 0 or this guy is equal to 0. So we have 2p plus 1 is equal to 0. So we say 2p is equal to 0 minus 1. So 2p is equal to negative 1. So we want to find p, so we get rid of 2 by dividing both this multiplication here. So this will cancel or will divide. That is 1 over 2. This is the value of p. Or, if this is not 0, then this must be 0. For us to arrive at 0. So p minus 3 is equal to what? 0. So p is equal to 0 plus 3. So p is equal to what? 3. Then we found the solution there. Alright. So now, this is how you apply this method to solve quadratic equations that are able to be factorized. So D, E, and F are meant for your exercise because they have all been covered by A, B, and C. I hope this presentation has been very helpful. If you like our work, our presentation, subscribe to our YouTube. Thanks so much. Till next time.